Hi, Dance Magazine readers. Welcome back to Dance Magazine's YouTube channel. My name is Haley Hilton, and this is the Begin Again vlog, where I am chronicling my return to the dance industry after 9 years off with a chronic health condition. Today, we are talking about cross training. Cross training is something that I knew was going to be important to discuss as I returned to dance. I think it's important for everyone returning from injury, returning from the pandemic, returning from pregnancy. Just taking class for the most part won't do enough to like protect you from injury and develop the strength or stabilization or whatever that you need to be on stage again. But for me, I knew that I only had so many spoons in a day and I wanted to use them for dance classes, and for a long time it was more than enough. I was still needing to pace myself with those things, and so I didn't want to like add something unnecessarily that meant that I would be too tired to go to dance the next day. I didn't want that, so I've pushed it off. But when I had my minor toe injury and I started working with a physical therapist, we started working on some things that may have caused my minor toe injury and weaknesses in my body that she found. And after a while, she finally said, you know, I think it's time for you to start adding some stabilization and strength training to you, and she wanted me specifically to do Pilates. And so I started adding that into my life, and it's been really helpful. I feel like I've discovered things about my body that I didn't know before, like I'm hypermobile. Well, my hypermobility makes it so I sit into my hyperextended legs, which means that I'm not strengthening hamstring muscles, which means that it's harder for me to jump because my hamstrings aren't that strong. Anyway, it's like one thing is connected to another, connected to another, connected to another. And cross training can help me be strong enough to dance better in class. One thing that's important for me to mention that I feel strongly about is when I was in high school and junior high and training before I got sick, I saw cross training as a means to like an aesthetic change in my body. The culture around dance is obviously not the healthiest in terms of body positivity, and that's just not something I'm subscribing to right now. I have so much respect for my body and what it has done for me through years of sickness and healing that I'm just not interested in looking at that side of things. So this cross training is not about aesthetic at all. This cross training for me personally is about stabilization for me because I'm hypermobile. It's about gaining strength because obviously there's strength that I need. And it's about building stamina because that's another thing with dance being so anaerobic that I don't feel like I have quite enough of yet in order to like do 8 shows a week. With that said, I decided to explore a bunch of different options to decide which cross training activity would be best for me. And here's what I did. So first, Pilates. I have loved it. I've worked with Jen Kreichman. Jen takes Nancy Bielski's ballet class with me. And it's so cool because we'll take class and then I'll have Pilates with her later that week, and she'll be like, oh, I noticed that you're struggling with this thing and I think it's because of this, and I can help you improve it this way. And then I apply it in my class and it helps my balance and it helps my toe pain because I'm not forcing over my like toe joint as much. I'm finding a little more steadiness. Hi, Dance Mag readers. Welcome back to Dance Magazine's YouTube channel. As you know, we are currently discussing cross training options for dancers, and I am here with Pilates instructor Jen Kreichman, and she's gonna talk to us a little bit before we get started about why Pilates is a good cross training option for dancers.
Pilates is an excellent cross training option for dancers because it addresses each individual dancer's challenges. Every body is different. Some people are hypermobile, some people lack flexibility, some people lack external rotation, and Pilates allows the instructor to look at each individual dancer, what their challenges will be, and create a program of training.
Hi guys, here we are at Candlestick Pilates. Jen is an instructor for Absolutely Pilates, and we're gonna get started.
All right, Dance Magazine readers, meet my very dear friend, Megan McFerrin. She is the creator of City Sweat, which she's going to talk to us about today. Just to get started, Megan, can you tell us about the origins of City Sweat, how it came to be, what it's all about?
Yeah, so I grew up as a dancer, similar to Haley, competition dancer my whole life, and moved to New York City to do the whole dance hustle, audition scene, everything. And I got into dance fitness as a side hustle while I was in between auditions. It was like such a fun, awesome way to make money while I was auditioning. And I found a deep love for dance fitness because every time I would go train someone who maybe wasn't a dancer or didn't have fitness experience, I got so much joy from the fact that I could still dance and do what I love, but there was no pressure of like auditions, people looking at you. How do I like, what am I wearing? What's my personality? And as I was navigating New York City, I was finding that when I was going into auditions, I was almost changing the way that I was to maybe like put on a facade or like to make the panel of whoever was watching me or whoever I was auditioning for to make them be like, oh wow, that girl's really standing out. And I found like I was being my more true self when I was doing dance fitness. So I created City Sweat by Megan, which is a dance inspired fitness workout basically, but it's more of a celebration of your mind, of your body, of what you can do and kind of taking off all of the pressures of like, I have to hit this turn as a dancer. Like I have to look my best, feel my best. And honestly, with a lot of you all being in the dance industry right now, City Sweat is a perfect supplement because it helped me find my true self so that I could carry that into the audition scene. So it's not like, oh, it's this or that. It's more like it's a supplement so that you can really find your true self, really enjoy movement, and then carry that into the audition scene, into the performance scene, and really find your true self, your true glisten.
And I love that you talked about like one of the benefits of City Sweat is that it's this low pressure, like one of the benefits is mental, emotional. It like gets you out of that space of like, I have to be on all the time, and more like I'm moving because it's fun and it feels good for me and it's not about anyone else, right?
Absolutely.
In terms of like strength and stamina, what are some of the benefits of City Sweat that you feel like is a good fit for dancers specifically for cross training?
Yes. Yeah, so all of my classes are 40 minutes or under, which I think is awesome because I kind of started it like a warm up for dancers. When I was first starting City Sweat, I would just have a bunch of my dancer friends come in and we kind of created the method. We go through a warm up, we go through arms, abs, legs, and different classes target kind of different muscle groups, depending on maybe what dance audition you're going to, what dance class you're going into next. But my main goal was to help dancers and then carried into non-dancers, but dancers specifically in this scenario, just feel ready for the day, ready for their dance class, ready for their audition. Their muscles are warm. It's building your endurance because we actually just flow right through all of the portions. Yes, you can take water, but it is like a really good flow and it's beat based. So you're finding your rhythm, you're finding your balance. We do a lot of ab strength and ankle strength, which is so important for dancers, but you leave feeling energized rather than like, oh my God, I just did a boot camp and like I lifted 20 pound weights. We don't do that. It's all low impact. It's all a celebration of selves. And it's all supposed to be for, all right, I killed my 30 minute City Sweat. I killed my 20 minute class and I'm ready to go. I'm ready to dance for the day.
I love this. I love this. This is a really, I think a really great supplement. I loved your class. It is so fun. And I also love, you are just so special. Like you bring this energy into a classroom that is like, it's like joyful and positive and uplifting and funny and charming. And so, yeah, everyone, you can follow Megan on Instagram. I'll put her link in the story or her handle in the story. Wow. And yeah, follow City Sweat. And this is just a great cross-training option. So thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. Welcome to join it. Just head over to the City Sweat app. You can find everything, anything, little arms, little abs, whatever you want to do. You want to get fired up, energized for your day. I got you.
I really just want you to celebrate your body, celebrate yourself. Like, you don't do it enough. So don't think of it as a workout. It's just like a freaking celebration and a party. Okay, for my next fitness thing, I'm going to Bryant Park. They're doing a yoga class. I love yoga. It's something that feels really good in my body, which probably means that it's not the right cross training option for me, because it's like, I'm already pretty flexible, and so it's just nice to just kind of sink into some of the movements. So my PT was like, man, that's probably not what you need, but it's still fun. So I'm gonna go do this today because it brings me joy. Meeting some friends, it'll be pretty magical. Let's see how it goes.
Now sun wraps all the way up. Exhale, ease with that heart. Swan dive down. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, float it back to plank. Lower down, chaturanga. Point the toes, up dog. Curl those toes, down dog. Ease, you got it.
Bring your hands forward, step it back to plank, lower down, chaturanga, up dog, curl the toes, down dog, lift that left leg up, three-legged dog, coming into pigeon on the left, good, thank you so much, nice job.
Hi Dance Mag readers, I'm here with Melissa Wolfhauer. She's gonna tell us a little about what gyro is and why she feels like it's good for dancers.
What you just experienced, we call the gyrotonic expansion system. It started by Julia Horvath probably over 30 years ago, who was a dancer. And what you see now is an iteration of years of exploration into a holistic way of moving the body in a way that decompresses the joints, allows a greater range of movement, allows coordination of movement. It awakens your nervous system. Dancers generally need to marry flexibility and strength, but have a good balance of that. They need a wide range of motion in their bodies. You're looking for like all the ways that you can express yourself with your vessel. And one of the things that gyrotonic is good for is increasing range of motion in joints or series of joints, yet also strengthening all the musculature around those joints so that you have a nice balance, which helps prevent injury, helps more efficient movements.
So yeah, this is gyro. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having
all
me.
All right, wonderful.
Give me some time to think. I'm in the bathroom looking at me. Facing the mirror is all I need. Wait until the reaper takes my life. Never gonna get me out alive. I will live a thousand million lives.
Training for me that I find most pleasant is walking. I come and I walk my dog multiple times a day because he has to be walked. But I try to make one of them like a brisk walk that keeps my heart rate up enough so that it's like cardio for 30 minutes. I just looked at the internet and asked the internet what your heart rate should be for a consistent amount of time for it to be considered cardio based off of like my age and weight. No, not weight, age and I don't know, other numbers. So I did that, found it, and then I just used my Apple Watch to help me like keep that up. And so that is what I'm doing now. I'm taking my dog through Central Park. So some of the things I like about walking is like I mentioned, it doesn't take up too many spoons, so I feel like I still have energy for dance. But it also gets me outside, particularly like during those first 3 months of the pandemic here in New York, we like didn't leave our apartment at all. And getting a dog got us to go outside on walks, and I feel like it was so good for my mental health to leave the space, to be in nature. So much of my life is spent like in buildings or between buildings, and it's nice to be in green spaces. In black and white, there was never wrong till there was right. Feeling like a bullet hurtling, seeing all the vultures circling. Alright people, it is 94 degrees in New York City right now. It is so hot, and this is probably a very irresponsible choice that I'm about to make, but I'm on a time crunch, I've got a deadline. I don't miss deadlines, so we're making it happen. Alright, the exercise that I'm going to do today is bike riding. My physical therapist told me that she felt like this was a good option for me in terms of building stamina, and that it won't be hard on my joints or cause problems for any of the funky little injuries that I have happening. So, we're gonna come ride a city bike around Central Park today. Honestly, I'm shocked that so many of these are gone because it's so hot today. Everyone's bike riding? Okay, I got my bike. Here it is. Something you should know about me is that I'm actually not a good bike rider. Like, I learned to bike as a kid, and like, I did fine, but I've hardly ridden a bike since childhood. There's traffic and rules that I don't know, and so this is not safe. Alright, I already had to make a stop and have my husband help me lift the seat up. So weak and so... This is not a good omen. It's not a good start. And I'm not supposed to be on the sidewalk, but I am because I'm going the wrong direction. Okay, I really did not like riding in the city. There were like other bikers in the bike lanes, and I'm like, can I ride here? There's no bike lane there. Are you okay? And they are all these amazing bikers just veering in and out of cars and things, but they were like, yeah, you're fine, there's no bike lane, but you're fine. I'm like, okay. I hate this. I don't think I'm cut out for this. This is a super workout. My quads are firing, and my hamstrings. That's probably good for my jumps because I would like to be able to jump higher, so maybe this will help. But oh, I'm gonna be so dead, and it's so hot.
This is magic. All right, I take it back. I initially had a bad attitude, but it ended up being really lovely, and I'll definitely do this again as exercise, but more fun with other people, I think, and more safe. But yeah, thanks for following along, guys.
Cross training can be expensive. The barrier to entry for dance is so high. The cost is unreasonable. It's disturbing and upsetting, and I'm subscribing to it in many ways and making sacrifices for it because I love it, but it's really hard for me and may not be possible for others. And so I really appreciate cross training options that are free, like walking in the park, you know, or cheap, like hopping on a city bike, or, you know, getting friends together and doing our own something. Like, it doesn't have to be expensive. One thing that Heidi discussed with me that she really wanted to emphasize is that just like everything else in dance and life, it's like very individualized. So what works for me might not be what works for you, or what I need might not be what you need, you know? And so she recommends, again, talking with an expert who can help you discover what's best for you, and then try things out for yourself and see what feels right on your body. In these cross training options, I've shown some options for stabilizing things that I need stabilized, strengthening things that I need strengthened, building stamina, and bringing joy and being good for my mental health. I think for me, the most beneficial way for me to cross train is to not be so strict and stringent on how I'm gonna schedule myself out, but I need a mix of these. I want a mix of these for balance. I think the life is just better when you have balance, and I'm not gonna hold myself. If I miss something one week, who cares? But that's my general idea. All right, my camera died, so I had to transition to a new camera. Sorry about that, but anyway. Thank you so much for following along, you guys. It means so much to me. To get to share this journey with you is really special to me. And it's meant so much to hear those of you tell me that you are in a similar situation, or that you can relate to different things that I'm going through, and the camaraderie that we find in this. It's beautiful for me, and I hope it's been good for you guys too, or that you've liked it at least. I don't know. Thank you. And come back next month. Thanks for following along. Mwah!